Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Social Security Horror Stories, Protect Yourself from the System and Avoid Clawbacks, by Laurence Kotlikoff and Terry Savage, narrated by Terry Savage and Alexander Kotlikoff. This book is dedicated to the millions of Americans who have contributed faithfully to Social Security all their working lives and who deserve better treatment. And as we read this to you, we invite you to come to our website, socialsecurityhorrorstories.com, for updates on our progress, and sadly, if it happens to you, to post your own horror story. Introduction. Social Security was created out of a dream to make all Americans' lives far more secure. The initial goal was that no older American would live in poverty. That dream has turned into an actual or potential nightmare for each of us, old or young, rich or poor, healthy or disabled. The nightmare comes in a letter clawing back benefits that Social Security now says it paid out in error. Social Security is quietly issuing hundreds of thousands of clawback letters every year. Its 2022 annual trustees report says recipients collectively owe $21.6 billion because of Social Security's mistaken overpayments, essentially none of which appear to be fraudulent claims. Compared to Social Security's total yearly outlays, $21.6 billion is a relatively small number, but it is a financial disaster for those who depend on their monthly benefit. Even worse, Social Security's demand letter comes with no explanation, no proof, no accounting for their error. Instead, it comes with a demand for immediate repayment or the threat that money will be withheld from future benefit checks, tax refunds, wages, or whatever they can grab in a lawsuit. At any point in time, millions of households are experiencing or contesting Social Security's basic rule: our mistake is your problem. In other words, when Social Security makes a mistake, it bears no responsibility or cost. You are the one who must repay, immediately out of your savings, or through cuts in your future Social Security benefit checks. In fact, you may never have personally filed for Social Security and still receive a clawback letter. Since Social Security bears no cost for its egregious mistakes, it has absolutely no incentive to fix its software and train its staff to get things right. Its mistakes cost the system vital resources and billions in administrative dollars, funds needed to help cover Social Security's huge financial shortfall. Now, these clawback letters can be for $175 or $304,122, actual clawback amounts we have seen. They can arrive soon after benefits begin, or as long as 45 years later. They can come for benefits you technically received at age 2, for which your now deceased parents applied. The clawback letter can appear the month your husband dies, announcing that your widow's benefit isn't coming for the next 18 years in order to recover excessive retirement benefits paid to the spouse you buried last week. These demands fall particularly hard on the poorest among us, senior citizens who depend on their monthly checks for basic needs, and disabled families who have no other source of income. Confiscating benefits when recipients are unable to work can represent a financial death sentence. Minorities are disproportionately poor and thus disproportionately victimized. Clawback letters all have common denominators: deadlines, threats to cut current or future benefits, and no justification. Each letter is admitting a mistake, but with no explanation, no one can tell whether the alleged mistake is itself a mistake. Everyone grabbed by Social Security's merciless claw is in the same boat, powerless to deal with a bureaucracy that violates all norms of due process and provides no explanation of its actions. It's a bureaucracy that rarely responds, leaves you on hold for hours, schedules calls that never come, always deflects responsibility, and keeps virtually no records of your case. This book confronts the system that is quietly overwhelming our most vulnerable citizens and indeed all of us. It's also about terrible scams Social Security is running, of which few are aware. These include the widow's scam, the use it or lose it scam, the earnings test scam, and the take your benefits early scam, not to mention Social Security's incredibly sexist provisions. Some can cost you a small fortune over your lifetime. All are intrinsically linked to Social Security's foundational financing scam, and all are described here, along with advice on protecting yourself. This book is not about addressing future solvency of the Social Security system, which its trustees have clearly revealed. Yes, within a decade, unless substantial reforms are made by Congress, Social Security will find itself unable to pay out the promised benefits in full, and that comes as no surprise. But instead, we want to reveal today's horror stories happening to your mother, father, child, or friend, even as we write this book. Left unchecked, you may be the next victim. These are outrages that can and must be confronted immediately. We are two distinct voices who find ourselves in perfect harmony when it comes to sounding these alarms. We both seek to fix Social Security, not end it. We both think that a well-functioning Social Security system is essential. But so much of what's going on now under Social Security's hood makes a mockery of the system's title, specifically the word security. We both write for the public about personal finance. Larry Kotlikoff is a Boston University economist, and I, Terry Savage, am a nationally syndicated columnist. We learned about clawbacks from readers describing their personal horror stories. Over time, we realized the stories coming our way were just the tip of the iceberg, that millions of Americans were being clawed back and caught in Social Security's impenetrable bureaucracy. As for the scams, we are both students of the system. We know all the good the system is doing and precisely where its bodies are buried. It's time to pinpoint those graves. To reiterate, this book is not about all the well-publicized concerns over the future solvency of Social Security. Instead, it is about the dysfunction of the current system that is causing massive financial pain now for so many Americans. We do, however, expose the system's original sin, lying about the nature of its financing. One lie begets another, and the system's original lie has turned deception into a basic operating principle. Avoiding your personal horror story in three parts. Our book has three parts. The first, I've written. It details personal horror stories that are truly unbelievable. We are not writing a Stephen King novel. This is nonfiction. We are letting you know precisely what's happening in the actual words of the clawback victims to so many of us today. Part two is written by Larry. It's about Social Security's aforementioned terrible scams that are secretly harming millions of us and our children, being induced to check an extra box on a form and losing hundreds of thousands of dollars in future benefits, making a lifetime of Social Security contributions in exchange for not a single red penny of extra benefits, remarrying a day before 60, and losing widow or widower's benefits from your deceased former spouse, being conned into not returning to work under the threat of a massive tax that isn't, and the list goes on. Part three is our combined advice on how to avoid clawbacks and the system's other traps. Indeed, there are simple steps you can take to avoid your own horror story. This will require a bit of work on your part. You'll need to create your own assessment of benefits owed to you instead of relying on Social Security's calculations. Your efforts will provide a huge payoff. You will know that the benefits you receive are exactly what you are owed. The computations will be easy once you input your information into the inexpensive, user-friendly tool MaximizeMySocialSecurity.com, which was developed by Larry. It can tell you if you are being overpaid or underpaid if you're already collecting, as well as what you should receive once you start collecting. Now, many commercial programs may also get these calculations right, at least in simple cases. But you need to act before the error adds up to a small fortune, your retirement fortune. Social Security may take 40 years to figure out a mistake. The amount of a clawback can be astronomical. $304,000 is the highest we've seen to date. We prescribe remedies for this unacceptable failure of process in the Social Security Agency. Some involve money to update the creaking computer systems that fail to gather information and track its processes. But other fixes involve the leadership of this important agency to create a culture of service and training that enables hardworking employees to fulfill the agency's pledge to provide superior customer service. In that regard, we recommend Social Security create an ombudsman office, similar to the Taxpayer Assistance Center at the IRS, where problems can be resolved immediately, understanding that time is of the essence. We're also going to enlist you in a collective mission, ending Social Security's financial malfeasance, including the system's Ponzi scheme that's threatening to ruin our retirements and bankrupt our children. Through our joint efforts, Social Security can be the system we revere, not the system we fear. Let us tell you more about our background so you'll know we are here to protect you. Larry and Terry. Larry is a Boston University professor of economics. As his Kotlikoff.net website makes clear, Larry works on everything from climate change to healthcare to tax reform. But his passion, exemplified by his software company and his latest award-winning book, Money Magic, An Economist's Guide to More Money, Less Risk, and a Better Life, is conveying economics-based personal finance. He's on a mission to help people plan their finances properly, as economics and common sense prescribe. In 2022, Larry was honored with the SABU Award. That stands for Society of American Business Editors and Writers, the award for Money Magic, the top personal finance book of the year. Larry founded his software company, Economic Security Planning, Inc., in 1993. He's never taken a penny of salary. He works for free for two reasons: to compensate his employees, full disclosure that includes two relatives, and to keep the prices of his company's software tools as low as possible. His best-selling book, Get What's Yours, The Secrets to Maxing Out Your Social Security, was co-authored by Larry, Paul Solomon of PBS NewsHour, and Phil Moeller, longtime personal finance journalist. Terry Savage, that's me, is the best-selling author of The Savage Truth of Money, several previous books, and I'm a nationally syndicated personal finance columnist for the Chicago Tribune Content Agency. I've won a National Press Club Award for financial reporting. I appear regularly on WGN-TV and WGN Radio in Chicago, and I'm a frequent guest on national news programs. I'm also a registered investment advisor, though I have no individual clients, and a founding member and the first woman trader on the Chicago Board Options Exchange, as well as having been a trader on the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. Full disclosure, I now serve on the board of directors of CME Group for the past 20 years. My weekly columns are designed to demystify the financial markets and planning decisions. I answer money questions on the Ask Terry section of my website, terrysavage.com. As you can see, Larry and I have each dedicated our lives to helping people make smart money decisions. This book is an extension of our mission. Grab a drink, not necessarily a soft drink. Our first story comes from a victim who emailed me. She could be you, or your mother, or your grandmother, now or in a few years. This is one of many, many emails we received that made us realize we need to understand the magnitude of the system's clawbacks and other problems. So we both started writing columns. Larry on his Substack newsletter, larrykotlikoff.substack.com, and I in my syndicated column. They're all posted at terrysavage.com. We asked readers to send us their horror stories. Now, here's that first email from a widow named Ruth, who was horrified at a notice from Social Security telling her they had made a mistake and were clawing back $1,000 of benefits, potentially forcing her to sell her home. Terry, in May of 2021, I received a letter from Social Security stating I owe $88,734 because I was not entitled to my husband's benefits because I collect a pension. I went through all the process with the SS office, brought in all documents that were needed by them, and nothing was ever told to me by them that I was not able to collect. I filed an appeal but never heard from them until now. I am 73 and had a heart attack with triple bypass done. I don't want to lose my house. I have all the documents since this began almost 2 years ago. With COVID, they never would get back to me, and offices were always closed. Now they are threatening me. Please help. Ruth is not alone. Millions of seniors and disabled people are facing this nightmare. We will tell you their stories and more. In fact, we continue to collect these stories at our website, socialsecurityhorrorstories.com, where you can post your personal experience and get updated on our latest efforts to pressure the agency and Congress to make changes. Part 1, Social Security Nightmares. Chapter 1, Nightmares by the Numbers. Social Security pays out more than $1 trillion in benefits every year to some 70 million recipients. Most of that money goes to retirees and disabled workers. The rest is paid to their spouses, children, survivors, and former spouses. There are even benefits for dependent parents of deceased workers. About 11% of the payouts from Social Security go to disabled workers, as well as their spouses and dependents. An additional 7.7 million people receive Supplemental Security Income, SSI, which provides income support to needy persons age 65 or older, blind or disabled adults, and blind or disabled children. Now, you'd expect a system this big to make some mistakes. But Social Security makes routine mistakes, hundreds of thousands of mistakes every year. Mistakes that financially terrorize millions of Americans, many of whom are already living desperate economic lives. Unfortunately, those terrorized millions may include you, either today or tomorrow. The numbers are mind-boggling. We call them MIGO numbers. That stands for My Eyes Glaze Over. But when it comes down to your monthly benefit check, the numbers become very personal. Social Security estimates that 37% of men and 42% of women receive 50% or more of their income from Social Security. Approximately 15% of recipients rely on their monthly benefit for 90% of their income. A clawback or a cutback can mean the difference between food and medicine, between rent or homelessness. What's the root cause of these mistakes? It starts with Social Security's mind-boggling complexity. The system provides only 12 benefits, yet its handbook has 2,728 rules about those 12 benefits, and its Program Operations Manual System, POMS, has literally hundreds of thousands of rules about the 2,728 rules within the 12 benefits. Try it. Google SSA POMS, P-O-M-S, and start clicking on its links within links within links, which seem to go on endlessly. There are so many that Social Security doesn't even bother numbering them. Hence, no one actually knows the precise number of stipulations, caveats, exemptions, provisions, catch-22s, call them what you will, governing the 2,728 rules about the 12 benefits. Perhaps someday a political scientist will do a careful study. But our hunch is that Social Security constitutes the most convoluted Byzantine set of provisions, regulations, and restrictions that mankind has yet devised under the heading public policy. This is the magnificent achievement of members of Congress, congressional lawyers, and Social Security bureaucrats who have worked tirelessly for decades to construct a fiscal system that no one, including no one at Social Security, can fully understand. Now, such complexity is not ordained by the gods when it comes to designing a country's old age security policy. New Zealand's retirement benefit, the superannuation system, has just one rule: reach age 65 and receive a monthly check, the same check everyone else over 65 receives. And how long does that check last? It ends when you end. Full stop. The number and magnitude of Social Security mistakes. In 2021, Social Security sent 223,500 Americans clawback letters notifying that they had been overpaid, most it seems for years and some for decades. The terrifying letters run like this, quote, "We overpaid you X. Pay back X immediately or have your benefits stopped in full or in part." In just one year, they added $8.6 billion in newly discovered clawbacks, bringing their outstanding repayment demands to a total of $21.6 billion. By the time you hear this, the receivables will be substantially higher. Social Security points out that its payment accuracy rates are high. Indeed, the percentage of mistakes might seem small when you consider that Social Security paid out more than $1.1 trillion in benefits that year. But to the recipients, who had already spent those retirement or disability payments, the amounts are certainly not trivial. Your individual clawback amount could be $4,000, $35,000, or $300,000. Regardless of size, all clawbacks share a common denominator. The pay-or-else letter comes with no precise or even cursory explanation of the source of the overpayment, and by definition, this clawback comes at a time when most Social Security beneficiaries are too old or too disabled to go back to work and earn the money to pay off this demand. Here's what goes through your mind when you open one of these heartless and terrible letters. Your instinctive thought: is Social Security accusing me of fraud? Am I about to be hauled into court? Or did that young staffer I spoke to on the phone 10 years ago get something wrong? I mean, I told them to include that critical information. Could they have failed to enter it into the computer? Did they suddenly discover a mistake in my work record or suddenly credit my contributions to someone else? Maybe they didn't update my record when I married and changed names. Oh, did the local school system where I taught for 11 years not transmit my pension amounts to Social Security? I mean, the school system didn't participate in Social Security, meaning my Social Security is supposed to be docked based on my pension. All of this goes through your brain in rapid succession as your blood pressure heads towards stroke territory. And then you erupt. Oh my gosh, what is going on? Let me call Social Security. So you pick up the phone and spend hours on hold only to be connected with someone who's been on the job for 7 months and has no clue. But this customer support representative does set up a phone appointment in a month with a person who does know. When that day and hour arrive, which you've been focused on every minute of every day, because after all, your entire financial future is at stake, lo and behold, they don't call. Welcome to Social Security hell. And this is only the first circle of hell. In coming weeks, months, and even years, you will be introduced not only to the non-callback circle, but also to the lost documents circle, the not in this office circle, the our computers are down circle, and the you mistakenly checked this box, so too bad for you circles of hell. You are caught in the downward spiral that destroys your peace of mind and your financial well-being. Once you have become a target, the you, as in we overpaid you, message is not necessarily you. It could reference benefits paid to your mom on your behalf when you were a toddler and she was disabled. Now you're age 25. Your mom is dead. Social Security decides after all this time that it made a mistake. The logic behind their clawback claim on you? Well, since those benefits were intended for your use, you, at age 2, should have known it was an overpayment and set Social Security straight. In any case, it's time to pay up. If you don't, they will take action. That could include garnishing your current wages or reducing your future Social Security benefits. Not kidding. This happens. Listen. Can you appeal? Want to appeal? Of course you can. But be aware that more than half of appeals are quickly denied. Here's the attitude you're up against. Okay, be our guest. in a few weeks will almost surely reject your request for reconsideration. Then you have 60 days to appeal your case to one of our hand-picked, fully-in-our-pockets judges. They'll get to your case. It may take a year if you're lucky, 2 years if you're not, but eventually they'll get to you. Meanwhile, if you're currently receiving a check, be it your retirement benefit or a widow's benefit, a disabled child benefit, or any of our 12 benefits, we will immediately, starting next month, cut or stop your payment. If you are among the most vulnerable and surviving on Social Security, this clawback can literally condemn you to extreme poverty and an early death. The administrative law judge chosen and paid for by the agency can later decide, long after you've been cut off or cut down, that Social Security screwed up, or that cutting your benefit will defeat the purpose of the Social Security Act, and they can belatedly grant you a waiver. By then, you've lived years in penury. Or your appeal may be approved if you weren't at fault and if, quote, equity and good conscience, unquote, requires dropping the clawback. But sadly, the record of successful appeals is dismal. In Part 3, we'll discuss these two ways to contest your treatment, as well as how to try to get in front of a federal judge to adjudicate your case, a judge that's not on Social Security's payroll. Meanwhile, Social Security's mistakes put us all at risk. Don't think that Social Security's gnarled clawback letter won't show up in your mailbox. That letter is not, hey, we probably goofed up and overpaid you. Please call this number and we'll sort things out. Unfortunately, you owe us some money. No, no, no. On the contrary, it's, you owe us $37,527. Pay up or else we will grab it any way we can. And despite the agency's proclamation that no clawbacks will be made until an appeal is resolved, Social Security is routinely cutting, if not eliminating, current recipients' benefits to reclaim money that it claims but doesn't care to prove it overpaid. Not only immoral, but likely illegal. By the time Social Security discovers its own mistake, the overpayments it claims it made have likely been spent on basic necessities. Paying back spent money is generally extremely difficult, if not impossible, for most clawback victims. And withholding future benefits because of the agency's own mistakes, years after the alleged mistakes were made, is quite frankly immoral. When asked about this practice, Social Security responds, quote, "The Social Security Act requires us to adjust or recover benefits when an overpayment occurs. An overpayment is the difference between the amount paid to the overpaid individual and the amount to which the individual was entitled." Unquote. Is there no room for common sense or compassion in the application of the Social Security Act? In fact, there is room for Social Security to avoid these capricious confiscations. In three different sections of their regulations, specifically in 416.554 of the Code of Federal Regulations, there is reference to the term against equity and good conscience. That waiver is to be applied in situations, quote, where the individual changed his or her position for the worse or relinquished a valuable right because of reliance upon a notice that payment would be made or because of the incorrect payment itself. Let me explain. For example, this reliance would apply when a Social Security recipient decided to retire based on the benefit Social Security told the recipient he or she would receive. And it would equally apply to other work and life decisions made based on the benefits a recipient was told to expect was actually receiving from Social Security. I mean, everything from taking another job to spending money on a new car or on a vacation would be impacted by a person's reliance on income provided by or expected from Social Security benefits. And certainly that person never expected to receive a huge bill for repayment of benefits at this stage of his or her life. In 1992, the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals ruled that this term, quote, against equity and good conscience, unquote, should be broadly applied based on the case of a person, quote, who was without fault in receiving these payments, unquote. Now, if an attorney were to bring a class action suit for the millions of Americans who have been clawed back already, to the tune of billions just this past year, and all those currently in process of being clawed back, this court ruling, which came in the case of Quinlivan versus Sullivan, would provide the perfect legal justification. Clawing back benefits from dependent retirees and disabled persons because of mistakes made solely by the Social Security Administration is clearly against equity and good conscience. Chapter 2. The Claw in Your Mailbox. Let's start with a simple premise. Few people come to Social Security knowing what their benefits should be. By the way, the exceptions are those who use Larry's MaximizeMySocialSecurity.com software. We'll describe it more in a while, or equally accurate commercial software. But most people come to Social Security to ask about the amount of their benefits, and they likely ask for advice about their claiming choices. Now let's add one more basic premise to our discussion. Most of the people who come to Social Security asking for help are either seniors about to claim retirement benefits or disabled people who may have other challenges and health issues. In other words, they are likely the least sophisticated about technology and the most likely to need help. And let me add a final premise. People don't come to Social Security to claim benefits unless they believe they're entitled to something based on their work record or that of a spouse, an ex-spouse, or a parent. They correctly assume they're entitled to a benefit because they or their current or former relative contributed to the program over the years. Bottom line, those who contact Social Security are almost always dependent on the information and advice given to them by the telephone representatives and online calculators at socialsecurity.gov. Customer service? Well, given this, you would think that Social Security would have learned a bit about customer service over the 88 years of its existence. It certainly gives lip service to the concept. Its homepage at ssa.gov proclaims, quote, "We are passionate about supporting our customers by delivering financial support, providing superior customer service, and ensuring the safety and security of your information," unquote. Well, the reality falls far short of this lofty mission statement. When you call your car dealership for service, the company immediately brings up your service record, tracking your last oil change or brake repair. You would think Social Security could just as easily set up tracking files of all their decisions about a claimant's benefits. Social Security says it records all telephone conversations, yet even when requested, it cannot find them to adjudicate blame for wrong advice. You would think each employee would have a badge number or direct phone extension contact number to make follow-up easier. You would think Social Security would hire people who know that their job is to serve their clients, the claimants, and would give employees the tools to make their work easier. But despite its stated mission, Social Security appears to have no training program that prioritizes this supposed commitment to serve its dependent clientele. In fact, far too many Americans will tell you that their experiences with Social Security are beyond awful, and they have sent us their horror stories to prove it. Throughout this book, their stories are told in their own words, only lightly edited for length. Their emotion shows through, and it is mostly pain. Let me tell you Jean's story. My name is Jean. I applied for Social Security in June 2014 and was told I'd receive $1,903 every month. Thinking this was high, I asked for a recalculation from our local office and was told it was correct. In June 2018, they told me it was too high and should have been $422 a month. They wanted the overpayment of $72,343 in 30 days. I appealed, but could never get to an administrative hearing. They told me I would get one in October 2019 and restarted my monthly payments, only to stop them again in 2021 because no hearing was held. Then in July 2022, they indicated they would send additional information regarding a hearing, but it never came. They are still garnishing my benefit, which now includes my spousal benefit on my husband's monthly benefit. To date, I have repaid approximately $21,800. The frustrating part of this is that they twice told me the original $1,903 was correct, and I accepted the benefit based on their confirmation. Now I won't receive a benefit until I'm 76. Thank you for anything you can do. That's Jean's story. If Social Security doesn't get the correct calculation at the start, you will be drawn into the vortex of darkness and financial destruction. Social Security made the original mistake, and many subsequent mistakes, and with its power over your current and future benefits, you will continue to suffer while it endlessly shuffles the problem around internally. Social Security's complexity and information requirements breed mistakes. Of the many sources of Social Security mistakes, human error by Social Security...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.